Welcome back to our course on Project 2013. In this section we're going to look at the ribbon. So we're going to start with blank project. And the ribbon is this rectangular area that you can see towards the top of the window. The ribbon replaces the old menu system, and in most of the components of Office, the replacement started in Office 2007, and although they've progressed at different paces within the different components, in Office 2013 the ribbon is pretty much universally now at the same stage of development. So if you've used the ribbon in something like Word or Excel, then in Project there won't be any great surprises. The ribbon actually is a rectangle with a number of symbols on it, and the symbols represent different kinds of commands, options, buttons, settings and so on. And in the case of Project, we're going to be looking at an awful lot of those during this course. Now, you can see one set of these buttons here, and the buttons on the ribbon are divided into groups. And in turn, each of the sets of groups occupy one tab. Now the tabs are along the top here. There's a task tab, a resource tab, a report tab, project tab and view tab. And they are pretty much always there when you're using Project 2013. Currently I have the task tab selected. You can see that sort of rectangle around it that tells me it's selected. And on the task tab you have groups. There's a view group, a clipboard group, a font group, a schedule group, and so on. And each group has a number of buttons, a number of commands in it. The view group here has just one, that's called Gantt chart. The clipboard has four, the font has about seven or eight. Now, depending on the resolution of your screen, you may see more or less commands in these groups. You may indeed see more or less groups, because Project 2013 does is to fit as much in as it can, and it will vary to some extent depending on the size of your screen, the resolution, etc., and one or two other things that we're going to look at in just a moment. So that's the task tab. Let's look at the resource tab. Click on resource. You see the resource tab that has its own set of groups: view, assignments, insert, properties, level. Report tab, project tab, view tab. We'll be looking at all of these during the course. Now, in addition, at the moment there is another tab, a format tab, and you notice it's got this sort of light lilac-y colour background, Gantt chart tools. Some of the tabs on the ribbon only appear in certain circumstances, and they're called contextual tabs. Now, at the moment, we're looking at a Gantt chart. Now, it's actually not much of a Gantt chart because it hasn't got anything in it at the moment, but you can tell it's supposed to be a Gantt chart because it says Gantt chart down at the side here. And when we're showing a Gantt chart, we will get the Gantt chart tools format tab, which again has got a different set of commands on it arranged into groups. Now, let me just go back to the task tab at the moment. And on the left here where it says view and it says Gantt chart, let me just click on there, and I'm going to choose a different view. I'm going to choose a view called network diagram. Now, what happens with the network diagram selected is that I get a different view. The view won't tell me much at the moment because, as I say, I've got no tasks. But with the network diagram, I get network diagram tools format tab. That has a different set of groups and commands on it. So we have these contextual tabs, and which contextual tabs you can see at any time depend on what you're actually looking at, and to some extent on what you're doing at the time. Now, the contextual tabs we'll look at as we go through the course, and as I introduce different views, different types of objects and so on, I will introduce many of these contextual tabs. Now, we're back at the task tab here. The next thing I want to point out to you is that depending on what you're looking at and what you're doing, some of the commands on the ribbon may be enabled and some may not. So if you look at the task tab at the moment, you notice there that we've got a row of buttons there with little percentages written on them that are actually enabled. If you clicked on those, they would do something. The button right on the left, this one that says Gantt chart, the one we used just now to switch to a different view, network diagram view, and back here to Gantt chart view, that's enabled. We can use that. But the paste button is not enabled. It's grayed out. You can click on it. It won't do anything. At any one time, you would expect that some buttons are enabled and some are disabled. And as is the convention in a Windows interface, commands that are disabled are grayed out. So be aware of the fact that the buttons that are not grayed out, you can use at any time. And the ones that are grayed out, you can't. Now, if you're using touch, then you would switch between these tabs by tapping on the names of the tabs: task, resource, report, project, etc. And then to execute a command, you tap on the command, maybe choose some options if there are options. But there's a very important aspect of using touch with a ribbon, and it's universal across the components of Office 2013. And that is that there are two modes of operation. There is mouse mode, which is what I'm using at the moment, and there is touch mode, which I want to show you next. Now, to switch into touch mode, for those of you who are using touch, you're going to use this little button here, the screen tip that pops up, touch stroke mouse mode. You can see it there. That is the tip that tells you this button, which is actually on the quick access toolbar, is the one you use to switch between the two modes. Now, if you click or tap on the little arrow there to the right of the pointing finger, you get a choice: mouse, which is the current selection, or touch. I'm going to tap on touch, and I am now in touch mode. Now, the important thing to note here is that you have the same tabs and basically the same groups, although depending on the tab and the situation and screen resolution, etc., you may not be able to see all of the groups at every time, and the number of commands in some of the groups may be reduced in touch mode, because basically what happens in touch mode is that everything is spaced out more to enable you to operate it with your fingers. I pointed out to you just now that little sequence of buttons with percentages marked on them. They would be incredibly difficult to use with your fingers, as they were just now, all sort of scrunched up tightly next to each other. If you look at that same row of buttons here, you can see that in touch mode they're spaced out widely enough that you can use them with the tips of your fingers. So if you're working in touch mode, you can switch to touch mode, and if you want to, you can just stay there. I'm going to switch back to mouse mode. Now, I'm actually going to switch back using my fingertips, but I'm going to switch back to mouse mode, and from now on I'm going to use mouse mode in this section, but be aware of that setting for touch. So tap on that button again, tap on mouse, and I'm back into mouse mode again. One of the problems with using the ribbon is that it does use up rather a lot of space on the screen. And sometimes when you're dealing with a large complex project, you may say, I wish the ribbon was a bit smaller, or I could just get it out of the way to give myself a bit more space to work with. Well, there is a way of doing that. You may not want to use this approach early on in your use of Project 2013, but when you've been using it for a while, this will very probably be something that you like to do. If you look towards the right hand end of the ribbon, there's a little up pointing arrow there, and the screen tip that comes up is collapse the ribbon. And if you want to collapse the ribbon, basically you click that and the ribbon is now out of your way and you've got a lot more space to work in. Now, you may see that the most obvious disadvantage of doing that is you no longer have access to the commands that you need to execute in order to work on your project. But the assumption here is that you know pretty much where all the commands are at this point, and all you really need to be able to see are the tabs. And if I say wanted to switch from, say, Gantt chart view into network diagram view, I know that's on the task tab, it's the left hand command. All you then have to do is to click on task, go to that command as we did just now, click there, change to network diagram view, select network diagram. Project 2013 switches into network diagram view and minimizes the ribbon again. So not only does it execute the command, but it puts the ribbon out of the way again as well. Now, when you're confident enough in your use of Project 2013, you may want to choose that approach to give yourself some more space to work in. Now, if you take that approach to collapsing the ribbon, there may of course come a point in time where you decide maybe you're doing something different you haven't done before and you need to be able to see the ribbon all of the time so that you can find the right commands, or indeed you're using one of the contextual tabs that you're maybe not so familiar with. Then if you right click, say, on one of the tabs so you're sure that you're using the ribbon, one of the options there, collapse the ribbon, the bottom one, just uncheck that, and the ribbon is expanded and you can see it all of the time again. And just one other thing I'd like to look at in relation to the ribbon here. If you right click somewhere on the ribbon, you see a number of options here, and one of them, customize the ribbon, second from the bottom. Click on customize the ribbon. That actually takes you into the project options that we're going to look at later on in the course in detail. But one of the pages on the project options is Customize Ribbon. Now, this is outside the scope of this course. I'm not going to go into this at all in detail now, but it may be something you want to find out for later on. And that is that you can customize the ribbon. You can add your own tab, you can create a ribbon tab of your own, you can create your own groups to put on it, and you can choose from the available commands in Project 2013 to make up that group or those groups on your own tab. There is a limit to what you can do to rearrange the standard tabs and groups, but you can certainly create your own. I pointed out the main tabs here, Task, Resource, Report, Project, View. There are some other standard tabs, Add-ins, Developer, Compare, Projects. And apart from the main tabs, there are tool tabs, a couple of which we've already seen. But actually there are quite a lot of tool tabs in Project 2013, and we'll see a few of those as we go as well. So as I say, this is outside the scope of this course, but if you find you are doing a job where it will be really helpful to have, say, a particular set of commands all in one place to save switching around on the ribbon all the time, then I suggest you look into customizing the ribbon. So that's it for the ribbon. In the next section, we're going to look at the quick access toolbar. I'll see you then.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Microsoft Project 2013 training to the next level, you can get 19 hours of Project 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.